There's a buoy hanging from a string inside of this jar. The lid of the jar is connected to a metal pole, and on the other side of it, there's another buoy hanging from another string and another jar. Both of these jars get filled up with water. And now, I'm gonna screw the jars back on to the lids. And when we do this, the buoys will stay on the top there. This one aside, let's get this other jar attached to its lid with the buoy in the middle. Great. Now, in the middle of the metal bar connecting these, you can see we've got a hole. And we flip this upside down. When we do this, both of the buoys come to the tops of the jars, and then we'll put the hole on top of this peg. When we do this, this means I can switch the position of the two jars by rotating around. I can even go faster and give this a big spin, which I'm going to do in a second. But here's the question. When I spin this rod that contains the two jars of water and the buoys, which way are the buoys going to travel? Are they going to travel toward the center? Are they going to travel toward the outside, or are they going to stay where they are? Now, if you know about centrifuges, centripetal force, whatever you think is the right answer is actually the wrong answer, and I'll explain why after I do it. So I'm gonna get these into position, I'm gonna give them a spin, and then when I spin, you can bring the camera here so we can see one really clear. And remember, whatever you think is gonna happen, the opposite's gonna happen, and the reason why is so crazy. All right, let's give it a big spin here. Let me make sure all of this is out of the way. All right, ready? Here we go. One, two, and three. Now the buoys, you think they would go to the outside, but they're actually going to the inside. They're going towards the middle of this thing. How can that be? And the answer is that when you spin it, the water is actually going to the outside. You can see the level of the water is higher when it goes farther away from the center. That means the water pressure is greater on the outside. The water pressure is less on the inside. And when you have a buoy in this controlled system here, it's gonna try to find the area with the least water pressure. And in this case, paradoxically, the area with the least amount of water pressure is closest to the inside. Usually if you spun something in a drum like this, it of course wants to go to the outside, but the buoys, they wanna go closer to the middle.